Hello, hello, beautiful Virgo, and welcome into my channel, The Rare Gazelle. My name is Reem, and welcome to your reading. This is going to be for Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, Virgo. I am going to walk you through your scrying channeled messages that I scried for you on September 19th, 9/19, and I will go through your spiritual growth messages and then your love reading, which will be time stamped in the comment section down below. Sometimes your love messages do intertwine with your spiritual growth reading, so we just flow here with the energy. So please take what resonates and leave what does not. Even if you're not a Virgo and you just feel guided to watch this message, I trust that there is something in here for you. Okay, so for beautiful Virgo, first I just want to say thank you. Thank you to my guides. Thank you to Spirit of the Most High. Thank you to my great-grandmother Nyla. Thank you to my grandmother Sophia, who's now in heaven. Thank you, ancestors known and unknown, for your support, your love, your protection, and your messages. And thank you to Virgo for allowing me to read for you today. Thank you. Amen. All right. So, Virgo, I received a vision for you, and I have been seeing the hermit in your spaces and in the visions for quite some time. So I know it's time to do a Virgo reading when the hermit reveals themselves to me. And so this time, no different, I received the vision of the hermit on a golden road. And I actually saw the golden road formulate. It almost appeared to me as if they were tectonic plates. The tectonic plates were shown to me, like very large moving pieces, like masses of land moving to formulate a road. And the road was golden, and you were on that path. And then I saw the star in your lantern ascend into the sky. And so the star is in the sky, the star that's in your lantern. So that's very symbolic. Could be like this North Star symbolism. I do feel as if you've surrendered something, you've let something go, but I feel like you are trusting yourself a lot more on this path. And there's something about that star with you and your inner strength and your trust with yourself. So I had a lot of inner strength come through. I saw a vision appeared of a golden lion. And the main message for you is that you are shifting years ahead of your life. And I do feel as if this is why they showed me these massive, pieces of land. They appeared as if they were like tectonic plates shifting to create this, this golden road. These shifts that you are creating for yourself today, your future self is going to thank you for them. You're shifting years ahead of your life. You're making something easier for yourself, for your future self. You're doing something today that is going to benefit you tomorrow and years down the line. You're walking the golden path. There's a lot of rejuvenation in your space, life, fertility. I also just heard new life. You've poured your all into it is something that I received. And I saw the Ace of Cups, and the Ace of Cups was being poured. And now that's interesting. Now I'm seeing, okay, so they're showing me this, like, oversoul energy from the star. Okay, hold on a second. Hold on. I just saw the star that from your lantern that ascended into the sky. I saw the star formulate into this like oversoul figure, this entity, which I believe is your, it's like your soul, your oversoul. And they took that Ace of Cups and they started to pour the Ace of Cups onto the road. So I saw, like, in the vision prior, I saw like the Ace of Cups just being poured onto the road, all the water, right? But it was constant. It wasn't depleted. It was like almost like infinite, this infinite energy, this infinite essence that you have is just pouring on this golden path. But now that I stepped into your energy doing your reading, I saw the star be revealed as your oversoul, and then the Ace of Cups be poured from your oversoul. So that's an interesting energy. Okay. Anyway, you're giving it your all today. Okay, sorry, my eyes just water from my allergies. So pardon me. you've poured your all today. You've given your all today, and it's making your life easier for tomorrow, okay, in the years to come. You're shifting years ahead of your life. We'll get more on the star over soul energy and that Ace of Cups vision pouring onto your golden path. I also felt like there were intense feelings carried over from a relationship or a connection. Some kind of significant connection in your life, some kind of significant relationship in your life. There's a lot of intense feelings around it, and it's being carried over. There's some kind of transmutation happening, occurring with the emotions that you feel towards this person, towards this connection. It's being carried over and it's being transmuted into something else, something that is being resourceful to you in this moment. And then again, the years to come, there's something that's being transmuted from that intense, from those intense emotions, and it's being utilized. It's a resourceful energy. It's resourceful to you, okay? I feel like you're freer to behave in a way that you would normally would not. You just feel just freer to me. Like there's this energy about you that's just, you're acting in a way that you normally would not. And so you may notice people around you noticing that you may be acting a little bit different, or you may be recognizing that you're doing something that you would normally do, but you feel so free. Like it is part of you. It's part of your soul to behave in such a manner, but you never felt as if you could behave like that. It could be because of judgment from the past or criticism from previous relationships, or just the way that you have been taught or your upbringing to not act a certain way or to behave a certain way. It could be the way you talk. It could be an interest of yours, a hobby of yours that you've always wanted to do, just something. I don't know. It feels a little bit risky, but it's not risky. It's like you're just behaving differently than you normally would not. And it's this freeing energy. I also do feel closeness and bonds getting stronger in the near future, okay? Or you could be experiencing that your relationships are becoming stronger because you are becoming freer, because you are behaving, such a weird way to say it, but you are becoming, let me say that, you're becoming more of who you are, and you're so comfortable in your skin, and you're so comfortable in who you are, and on this path that you have created for yourself. It's an interesting energy, a lot of interesting visions. So we're just going to flow, get in here. I want to go to the tea leaves and then the Lefruma Healing Oracle Rune Deck, which Rob, Russ, and I created. The link is in the description box below, all the way at the bottom where all the links are. They're on sale. You can order them. They're beautiful. All right. Thank you, Spirit of the Most High, for Virgo. I'm getting this like interesting energy on my chest. I feel like someone holds their breath when you're anxious, or there's something like you need to just like let go. I don't know if this energy of like feeling free, behaving in a way that you normally would not behave, but someone like holds their breath. You need to let it out. You need to breathe. Like, remember to breathe. Okay. January has been coming up a lot for people. I did channel yesterday. Who did you do yesterday? Aries. Aries got January. Wow, you have marriage. Okay, August. August was a really big month. a really big month for people. I feel like you poured your all into August, or there, because there were so many astrological events in August. I feel like you poured your all into August, or you did something very significant in August. Perhaps you made a wish in August. You created something new for yourself in August. You had a new goal, new dream, new wishes. Maybe you let someone go in August. Something very significant in August occurred. And Spirit is bringing up marriage and January in your energy of focus. I do feel like some of you may be getting married in January. Some of you, this is just very significant of a union, of a connection. And so this is what I'm feeling. There's intense feelings carried over. There's intense feelings that are carried over from a relationship. And this is what Spirit is bringing forward here. And it's funny they're saying it's being carried over. It's being carried over onto your golden path and being utilized as a resourceful frequency. I feel like I can't talk fast enough. My mind, these downloads in my mind, is just like my tongue and my speech can't catch up. I just want to talk as quickly as possible. Psychic ability, trust your intuition. I mean, we know that about Virgo. We know that about you guys. Holy. Do not back down from opposition. Show strength and fortitude. Bull. Oh, yeah. Some of you definitely may have Aries in your chart. I know that it's a ram for Aries, but I'm getting Aries energy here. You may benefit from watching the Aries reading. Okay, period of frustration, lessons to be learned. I'm just going to get a bunch of these out. Okay, just bear with me. I'm great passion at the bottom for Virgo. Reconciliation. Wow. Reconciliation does not come out often. You know, it's hard to believe because there's so many readings out there about reconciliation, but reconciliation is actually very rare. Extremely rare. Okay, I think that's it. Is that all? Alright, that's it. Wow. Interesting, Virgo. You have here clouds, temporary problems, and then you have your bridge. Whoops, sorry. Bridge, successfully overcoming a problem. Okay, so if you're dealing with something troubling, you know, this is a period of frustration. There is a lesson to be learned here, and I'm seeing you overcome that problem. That's what Spirit is saying. Do not back down. Okay, just show strength and fortitude and keep going. Okay, you're gonna overcome this problem. So there is reconciliation here. But this is interesting because that energy just shifted for me. It's like that tectonic plates. You're shifting a lot of things right now. You're using your intuition and you're shifting a lot. You're shifting a lot of things for yourself. Because you're using your intuition, you're using your third eye extremely methodically. It's like a very logical third eye here. Very logical. Very precise. You see things now that you have not seen before. You have created this golden path. And it's interesting because I'm seeing here the pineapple. The pineapple is this golden color. Let me see if they'll give us one more. You created these shifts. There's something about this reconciliation that is not what it seems. Because this third eye is looking at this pineapple quite shifty. It's almost like I'm squinting. Let me look closer at this. Yeah. Okay. Opportunities are waiting for you. Door. It's funny because I already see you on that golden path, but some of you, you're walking through the door. You're walking through the door. onto your golden path. I have to say something. Some of you keep reconciling with the person and you keep repeating a problem. Some of you keep reconciling with a person thinking that this reconciliation is meant to be, but you keep reconciling and repeating a lesson when they're just temporary. I'm sorry, that's just the way the energy is coming out. Because of the way you're looking at this reconciliation energy, it's the way you're looking at it now. You're looking at it differently. There's a new person here waiting for you. It's a new person. Opportunities are waiting for you. See, this energy is coming out in your spiritual growth message because there are such intense energies with this connection. There's such intense energies with this connection. I feel like you had a strong awakening with this person. This person was meant to come onto your path as you were spiritually awakening so that they can spiritually awaken you even more, so that they can open more doors within you. That's their purpose. That's their purpose. That's their purpose. It's an extraordinary connection, but it's I feel like you're coming to a point where you have received everything that you needed to receive from this person. And now you're moving through the door. Now you're on your golden path. I'm seeing Eight of Cups. I'm seeing Eight of Cups. Let me get one more shuffle in. Thank you. I mean, for beautiful Virgo. So it's interesting because we were saying how reconciliations are so rare. They really are. Reconciliations are so rare. Let me get one more. And I feel like that was the energy for you. It was like this person would come in and out of your life. And it felt like it was meant to happen. They were meant to come back into your life. And it's like you took pieces that you needed from them each time. But now, like, there's something shifty about this reconciliation because you're looking at it with this eye. And so it's like I'm getting this energy of just you. You may have like reconciled with this person more times than you needed to. Or you may have thought it was different. You're seeing this reconciliation for what it is, and it's just lessons to be learned. You're seeing the truth. You have your os and tear. Os tear. What? I'm getting a word. Os. Os tear. What is that? I don't know why. Like, I'm thinking that's a word. Is it the start of a word? I don't know. I don't know why they're showing me that. Anyway, if that needs to come back in, it will. You have here tear, smell. I'm going to read the poems because, you know, some of you may resonate very heavily with the poems. Proto-god, so old that time has smelted all emotions within. War and fury have been hammered, reformed, made over, recreated, refashioned. Through the compassion to understand all shadows, all destinies as part of the whole. Under the tutelage of tear, all blows, all hammer clangs and strikes. Glow from the flow of love. Love's breath he offers to all life. Wisdom is beauty and compassion, ageless. I feel like this tear, this smelt energy is your shifting process. And do you see that arrow and how golden it is? That's your golden path. You have created, you have smelted. I don't know if that's a word. You've smelted this golden path. And this relationship, this connection has played a really big part. Has played a really big part in the resourcefulness, the power, the awakening, the ascension, the process. This connection has allowed you or helped you, not allowed you, but helped you get deeper with yourself, has smelted all the emotions within. It's almost like identified all the emotions within, understood all the emotions within. You've made connections to yourself. You've made connections to problems or situations, experiences. You've solved unanswered questions. When connecting to this person, you have here Os, the God mouth. It's interesting, mouth, speak, the speech. It's interesting because like I was receiving so many downloads and I couldn't speak them out fast enough. But this poem says, sounds found deep in every cell call out. I'm shaking. There's a lot of energy. Forcing the source of the God voice of the earth's breath to burst and release. Each atom, an unhatched cosmic egg of unmatched mystical potential. To rise up is to speak up, to give song to ancestral codes of healing nestled in all of our vessels of the world's soul. Galdir, your best life, reach forward and commune. I'm gonna go to the dragons while these download in. You're reaching, it's interesting because I'm seeing this doorway as one of these cosmic eggs. You're entering a cosmic egg doorway. Even this pineapple is now looking like a cosmic egg. You're entering a cosmic egg doorway, meaning it's a deeper portal to self. It's a deeper portal to self. You're finding, yeah, look, carving your own path. And we said this in the beginning, you shifted to create this golden path. You're walking the golden path. You carved it, tear. You smelt it with the depths of your emotions. All your emotions within. I feel like you found your voice, Virgo. You found your voice. You have here vision at the bottom, contemplating the future. It's interesting because this is number 19, and I channeled on September 19th. 19 is a big number for you. This is also 119. You have, or sorry, this is number 119, January 19th. Okay, 1 January, but I'm also getting January of 2019 was quite significant for some of you. I feel like some of you are ending a 4-year cycle from 2019. You're ending a 4-year cycle, and there's like four corners of this doorway and a circle in the middle. They're pointing that out to me. Anyways, I'm getting the Three of Wands with this energy, contemplating the future. I see that you're in this energy right now. You've already carved the golden path. The golden path is here. I feel like you're sitting on your golden path right now. You're sitting on the path and contemplating the path ahead, contemplating the future. Let me get one more. Resilience, finding your limits. This is number 21. Going beyond your limits, going beyond limitations. I'm getting the number 211. Oh my God, that also came up. 211. You have your 19 again, the Desert Prince, survival and false promises. This is 1919. See, there's something with the number 19 for you guys. I know a lot of you, your birthday was September 19th, but 211 came up, I think, yesterday in Aries's reading. The false prince. False prince. Why did I say the false prince? Oh my God. What is happening? I said the false prince. I meant to say the false promises, but there are no accidents. The false prince. You have your selflessness, humility, and conscious action, number two. One more. Yeah, I'm seeing here 2121. Sisters of the season, cycles of growth, natural law, and then divine order. And then you have here the Swan Queen, transformation, intuition, and patience. Yeah, see, this person, their season is en has ended with you. You've grown past this connection now. It's just time to learn the lesson of why this person has been in your life and make a conscious action. I'm getting this energy that they were the false prince in your life. The false prince. I mean, it's coming up in the as this Prince energy, I mean, not female or male gender specific, but just they're saying it's a false prince. The true prince is here, awaiting you on your golden path that you have carved, that you have created. And there was this reading that I did for you where you were creating your soulmate. And here you are contemplating the future. Remember how I was saying that you have poured your all? You've poured your all with this resilience. energy. You have been extremely resilient on your path. You've also been extremely devoted to your path, devoted to yourself. You have poured your all into your experiences, into yourself, into your spiritual growth, into who you are. No matter what, you have shown up for yourself. No matter what, you have shown up. You've poured your all to the point where you have created these massive shifts in your life, and you've carved the golden path. Again, you're shifting years ahead of your life. And that's just contemplating the future, because your future self, I feel like this is your future self. I'm getting this just shifted for me. I'm seeing you. This is your future self sitting on the past, being thankful to your past self. Because you have shifted years ahead of your life. Your future self is going to sit comfortably on that golden path. Comfort with the true prince, the way they're putting it to me. Your future self is sitting comfortably because of everything that you have done today. Yeah, look at this. Yeah, the journey. the lower world. This is 31, and here you have 13, 31. So you do have here mirrored frequencies coming out. Yeah, the blade lately has been coming up to me as the eight of cups, because it's removing. The blade is also this beautiful air energy of finding your voice, okay, like that os, god mouth. And here you have completion, number nine. This reminds me of like the world and the ace of swords. You have here the staff, you have here the sacrifice, and the serpent, number 46. The serpent is healing. This is healing, but also the connection that you have with the higher realms, and then the lower realms, your connection to the higher and the lower worlds. The serpent energy, this is Kundalini, this is your spine, this is your connection. Okay, this is your connection, and that's what I'm seeing here, the staff. This is your spine, is what I'm seeing. And the serpent, the energy that flows through your spine to the higher worlds and your lower worlds. I'm getting this interesting vibration on the top of my head. It's actually really nice because I've had this headache for a while. It feels really good. It feels really good. You have here the sacrifice, 44. This is six. You also have here six. This is also six and nine. Okay, I'm seeing Cancer energy in your space. I'm now seeing the chariot in my head, my mind's eye. You can even see how the staff is coiled like a snake. Do you see that? I'm seeing like it's almost as if these two serpents, right? These two serpents are being coiled together around your spine. There's something strengthening within your body. I'm getting like this energy of like your backbone is strong. You're not going to go back. You're not going to go back. You're not going to go back to this door. You're not going to turn around and go through this door. There's something, again, it plays a really big role. A really big role in your life, in your growth. on your spiritual quest. It's almost like this is the last time that you're reconciling with this person to this degree. It's like the last, this is like the last reconciliation. The last reconciliation. It's just, it's such a important connection. I'm seeing like some of you may be experiencing body aches and pains. Obviously, I'm not a doctor. If there's something that is genuinely concerning you about your body, go to a doctor. I'm seeing that some of you may be experiencing very specifically back pain out of nowhere. Out of nowhere. You never have back pain. You exercise, like you do your yoga, you eat well. It's just like, why all of a sudden am I getting back pain? Okay? Because there's this massive upgrade here occurring in your body. Because there are shifts energetically, new vibration, new frequency, this golden path of new life, fertility, rejuvenation, your body is going through upgrades as well. Your energies are going through this doorway of higher awakening, higher ascension. So is your body. When your body goes through this doorway, your body goes through upgrades as well. Your body has to go through an upgrade anyways to even get past this doorway. Your energy has already been upgraded. Now it's your body. I feel like now your body is following, right? Your energy goes first. Your spirit goes first. Your oversoul is first. And then your body. Okay, then those denser energies, okay, the lower world frequencies then follow, okay? Then follow. Do you see that? I'm getting an interesting vision now. Remember how I was saying this is your future self sitting on the golden path? Sitting on that golden path. I'm seeing you on the other end. Like, remember how I was seeing that vision of the star that was in your lantern, it ascended into the sky, and then as I got into the reading, that star turned into like this entity, this figure, this oversoul. This is your future self. This is the star. The star that ascended into the sky is your future self. Is your future self. It's almost like you've let go this independence energy, this resilient force. It's like you've let go a part of yourself. You let a part of yourself go through the doorway. And that's this like freeing aspect of this freeing energy where you are just like behaving in a way that you normally would not. It's your future self that you're feeling because your future self is feeling so much comfort. You're shifting years ahead of your life. Remember that. Does that make sense? Your future self is sitting there pouring that Ace of Cups onto the golden path. And that water is like reaching your present self. There's something about like these two ends. Your future self and your present self on the golden path. This is your future self. And then there's your present self that like just walked through the door. Oh my God, right order. You have your natural law, divine order here twice. It's just the order of things. It's just the order of things. I'm saying it feels backwards. It feels backwards, but it's like I'm just getting this weird energy where like your future self is already experiencing the abundance, and your hard work that you have put in, you gave it your all, your future self is already feeling this comfort. It feels backwards, right? Doesn't it feel backwards? Meanwhile, your present self has just walked through the door. Immunity. This is protection. I'm also seeing this is a health message. Okay, this is a health message. Getting your immune system up. Okay, this is your body. Your body changing. Okay, we talked about that here. Immunity. I'm getting like your immune system getting stronger, your immune system changing. So pay attention to what you're eating, what you're ingesting, what you're listening to, what you're hearing, your surroundings. Okay, all of it is health, right? Your spiritual health, your energetic health, but also your physical health as well. Worthy. This looks like a beetle. I'm seeing a scarab beetle. When they open their wings, do they have wings? I don't know, but I'm seeing like a scarab beetle or some kind of beetle like open up. This is like rebirth. You're a rebirth of your worthiness, recognizing your worth, understanding your worth, drawing power from your worth. Oh my God, you can even see there's an egg. There's an egg here. Do you see that? Right there. That's an egg. That's an egg right there. Me get one more. Assistance. Oh, love. Okay, I'm gonna get into your love reading. I'm gonna get into your love reading. You have your assistance and love assistance. But do you see what I am talking about? This person, this intense feeling around this connection that you have had for quite some time. Some of you could have been married to this person. Some of you, it was just a connection in your life that you just felt very deeply for this person. This person felt deeply for you. It's because they assisted you. This love that they had for you and the love that you had for them, it was an assistance for your journey, for your worth, to find your worth, to find your voice, to find your power, to find your independence. Okay? It's for a season. It's for a moment in your life. Okay, now, okay, that it's interesting because they're giving it to me as like the false prince. Okay, it's like it's not, they may have been presented to you as someone that was like the one, or like there was like so many signs about this person to you. It's almost like it had to be that way in order for you to like dive deep and vulnerable. I know that kind of seems cruel in a way, but it was like to open your heart up. It was to open your heart up. Okay, it was open to it was meant to open your heart. Okay, and I feel like that's this sacrifice. You're sacrificing, you're giving away. You're giving away the false prince. Now let's channel the true prince. Oh, I'm so ready for that. Let's go. Let's do this true prince. Again, not female or male gender specific, okay? Like that's just the way that they're putting that energy forward. Okay, they're just saying it's a false prince and a true prince. Oh, beautiful Virgo. We're gonna get more messages, okay? Like coins is staring at me at the bottom of the tea leaf oracles. Okay, your finances. I'm just seeing like aces. I'm seeing a bunch of aces in my mind's eye. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't say the numbers for you. 10, 10, 6, 16, and 1, 1, 1. Okay, strong manifestation capabilities. You also have your 44. 19 is also really strong in your space. I don't know what 19 specifically means. You can look that number up. I'm also getting number 6, which is the frequency and vibration of love. You have your 10, 10, endings and new beginnings, completion. Completion brings in new beginnings. Completion opportunities are waiting for you here, doorway. Three of Pentacles is staring at me. This is work related. Opportunities with work opening up. Okay, like carving your own path, like whatever you want, Virgo. I mean, whatever you want. Whatever you want. Nurture whatever it is that you want. Nurture it. Nurture the energy, but most importantly, nurture yourself. Okay, nurturing yourself. I'm seeing a nurturing frequency. I'm feeling, yeah, you have your intuition again. This is number 55. You have to use your intuition really, really wisely. Very wisely, okay? I'm seeing this true prince is extremely nurturing, but I'm also seeing you're nurturing yourself, okay? You're nurturing your path. You're nurturing, I'm seeing Three of Pentacles. You're nurturing the Three of Pentacles. You're nurturing the things that you want to grow. Sorry, I just saw a plastic bag. It was just awful. Just saw a plastic bag flew by. I don't know if that fell from someone's balcony. Anyway, you have here overwhelm, number 11. Okay, the hard work we love can leave us feeling burdened, drained, and burnt out among other problems. Okay, so this could be something that you're experiencing, okay? Again, like this Eight of Cups energy keeps like coming into my mind's eye. Some of you may be feeling overwhelmed. Some of you may be maybe leaving things, people, places, and things that are having you feeling burdened, drained, and burnt out, okay? I'm also just seeing nurture yourself, okay? In those scenarios. Okay, let's get one more. Precision. Love it. The desire to do things precisely is useful as long as it does not dissolve into rigidity. This is number 69, and we did say 69 is coming through in your space. This Cancer energy I'm seeing, that cancer energy. The Chariot, I'm seeing the Chariot. Details is also coming through. Details. Examine your situation and take care of every detail one step at a time. This is you carving your path, being precise, being meticulous. This is going, your person, this true prince is going to mirror the way that you have created your path, created your golden path. Shifting years ahead of your life. Crazy. Oops, sorry. One moment. Yeah, that's just, it's crazy to me because I feel like your future self is already basking in this energy. Meanwhile, your present self just walked through that door. Again, it feels so backwards, but that's the way I'm seeing the energy. I don't know if that's like time is being weird or I don't know. Maybe that's just the right order of things. I don't know. Maybe that's just you, because you shifted years ahead of your life. Your future self couldn't already be in this energy. Yeah, look at the Wheel of Fortune. Right order. Okay, I gotta tell you something about this person. This person is very precise. They're very detail oriented. Wow, Knight of Wands. Knight of Wands and Two of Cups at the bottom. Two of Cups at the bottom. Look at the Four of Cups. See, I feel like See this false prince, survival, false promises, okay? That's this energy of the Four of Cups. I feel like with this again, like this beautiful connection that you had with this person, it's a potent connection. It's a soulmate connection, but again, they're only here for a season to help you, to assist you. It was an assisted love, right? It was to assist you, okay? And I feel like in the meantime, I feel like some of you took that connection, maybe you romanticized this connection, but it left you feeling drained, overwhelmed. It left you feeling dissatisfied here with the Four of Cups. But here now, look at this person going through this doorway. Right? Going through this doorway, right? That cosmic egg frequency. They're just going through that ring of fire like nothing. This is someone, again, they're extremely precise. They're going right through that ring of fire, extremely precise. It's like right on target, right down the middle. Chills. Hold on. Look at this. Why did I go to this deck? Look at this. See that intertwining energy here of the two flowers? And look at the staff. See how that coils? This is your person. See the details? You're going to notice the details. This person is going to see the details of this connection, of this energy. They're very detail-oriented. They're very observant. But you guys go together. You guys go together. It's almost like energetically. Energetically, I feel like you have been thinking. I'm seeing the Hanged Man. You have been under this perception, possibly also in a stagnant energy, thinking that you have been coming together and coiled and connected in this way with that false prince. But in actuality, you have been coiled and merging and connecting this entire time with the true prince. Some of you may not have met this true prince yet. I'm seeing January. There may be a small portion of you that have met this person, a very small portion of you, but time is being finicky right now. I feel like for most of you, this hasn't happened yet. And I don't always say that because I know everyone's on different timelines, but there's something about this energy that hasn't happened yet that I feel. And I always have to say how I feel. That's crazy. Like the fact, like completely two different decks. Do you know how thoughtful I am when choosing decks to do readings? I picked these cards yesterday, these decks of cards yesterday. I picked them up yesterday and I put them on the table and I wasn't energetically prepared to do the reading because Aries energy took me right out. And so this morning I had the decks that I picked for you yesterday and I spent probably 10 to 15 minutes just trying to figure out which ones I need to choose for you, which decks are best for your energy, and this is what I chose. And look what decides to come up as we were talking about that coiled frequency, that energy, the serpent force, the serpents. See, with the two heads, but they're coiled together. Your energies have been weaved this entire time that you have been thinking it's this person when it was actually them. I also want to say, like, the rod here. Do you see the rod? There's only one string that's being coiled around this rod, because this person has been on their journey. I'm seeing that. It's like you had your I don't know what to call that string, that coil of energy. It's like that's you, right? And that's them. But then along the way, your energy started to come together and coil together and to intertwine at some point. At what point specifically, I don't know. But at some point it did. Let me see. That's interesting. Five of Cups. Yeah, see, it's leaving. It's the leaving the past behind. Leaving the past behind. The High Priestess. Peeking through that veil. Peeking through that veil. I strongly feel like most of you, like 99% of you, like there may be that 1% that have met this person, but most of you have not. A lot of you are still in this energy with that false prince. You are so powerful in your independence. You're so powerful in your independence here, the High Priestess. You're so powerful in your intuition. How many times has intuition come out? Three times. You knew something about leaving this connection behind. There's something that you know. There's something that you feel deep down. It's this deep knowing to leave something in the past. To submerge yourself. See, you've submerged yourself in these emotions. Smelted all emotions within. You have carved all the emotions within. You have explored all the waters with that false prince. You have explored it all. You were in that depth. You were in that deep. Not only with this person, but with yourself. You've explored it. You've explored it. But then there's a part of you that knows it's meant to be kept in the past. And there's something here that is calling you, that you feel intuitively that there's something else. Look at that boat. That there's something else. That, see that Three of Wands energy? It's like that Three of Wands energy in the traditional tarot with the boat coming towards you. It's like, well, maybe there is something more. Maybe there is something more. And there is, because you feel coiled and weaved, and you feel something merging with your presence. You feel something merging with your soul, and it's this true prince. Maybe there's something more. Yes. Yes. There is. King of Pentacles. This person is well established. Look at this. Look at this beautiful golden light and golden energy around them. Well-established, financially judgment. I'm seeing someone make a decision about their career. Someone's making a decision about their career, whether to take something or to not take something. I'm seeing someone play the trumpet or some kind of instrument here. Oh my god, that King of Pentacles is a gorgeous, gorgeous frequency. Oh, the Emperor. Strong decision maker here, Ace of Pentacles, Ace of Cups. I'm telling you, what did I say? There's aces. There's aces. There's aces in your space. I'm seeing a new job for some. I'm seeing a new home here with the King of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles. I'm seeing finances are being like an increase in your finances here. I told Aries to play the lottery because I know Jupiter went. What? Sorry, I heard something and I was like, wait, what? I heard Jupiter went in reverse, but I was like, wait, what? Isn't it retrograde? Jupiter went into retrograde, but that doesn't mean bad luck. It's all about your perspective. Play, like, there's something about being in the energy when it's unexpected, or like what people fear you play in. There's something about here taking a risk, being in an energy that doesn't seem like there's growth, but there is growth. I don't know if that's a side message for someone, but there's something here where I feel like someone is in an industry where they were told no a bunch of times, and it felt almost as if like you were just knocking on closed doors, but there's one door that's going to open. Just because there are closed doors does not mean that you're not worthy of it. Just because there are closed doors does not mean that you're not worthy. It just means that that's not your door. Just because this person, this false prince, didn't give you something back romantically doesn't mean that you're not worthy of love. Five of Pentacles. Five of Cups, 5-5. What was 5-5 here? There was an energy that was 5-5. Hold on, I gotta find it. Precision, overwhelm. What was that energy? Nurture? Oh God, I don't know. There was an energy that was 5-5. I don't know where it is now. It's not details. That's 32. That is 5. But there, anyway, it's somewhere in the deck. That's okay. Do you do have your 5-5-5? I'm seeing new opportunities. Yeah, Three of Swords. See, it's like, there was some kind of romanticism about this false prince, and it wasn't meant to be romanticized. It wasn't a romantic connection in the way that you thought it was. I saw the Eight of Swords. Here's Seven of Pentacles. It's like you waited on that tree by yourself. I'm so sorry. It is heartbreaking. It is heartbreaking. It hurts. You rake the leaves, you forge this beautiful tree, you made this place a home, and this person didn't come because they were not meant to. That connection was not meant to be romanticized. But please don't block yourself off just because someone wasn't meant for you does not mean that you're not worthy of love. Just because a door closed in your face over and over and over again doesn't mean that you're not worthy of that thing that you desire, that you want. It just means that's not your person and that's not your door. But there is a door and opportunities that are waiting for you. This is about aligning yourself to that door. And let me tell you something, you have aligned yourself to those opportunities because you carved your own path. You are on the golden path. You are on the golden path. Look at all this gold around you. There's gold around this person, this true prince. This person is decisive. This person mirrors the frequency that you are on. The way that you have carved your path with such power, such strength, such fortitude, meticulous energy, decisive energy, carving your path, shifting things, seeing things the way you want to. That's the way this person is. They match you in that regard. The Emperor, Judgment, King of Pentacles. This person is extremely decisive and they take care of their own. They take care of their own shit. They have it together. They have it all together. This person is ready for love. This person is ready to create here with the Emperor and the Ace of Pentacles right beside him or her. But do you see the way the Emperor is staring at the Ace of Pentacles? I'm getting this energy of like, they like what you have done. They like what you have done. They like what you have created. They like the way you do things. They like the way you think. They like the way you move. They love what they see. They love what they see. They love that you can make something grow when there doesn't seem to be a way. There's something that you give to this person that they have not necessarily seen before. You're giving this person an experience. This Emperor is almost as if experienced a lot of life. I'm getting this very mature energy from them. They have experienced so much of life that it's really hard to surprise them. But you surprise them. You surprise them. Not just by your magic and your intuition and how powerful intuitively you are spiritually. But how powerfully you love. How powerfully you nurture. Do you remember how I was seeing the Ace of Cups? And I saw the Ace of Cups being poured onto the golden path by your oversoul. Look at the Ace of Cups being poured. Pouring out butterflies. I'm telling you right now, your future self is already in this comfort. Your future self is already experiencing this energy. You're shifting years ahead of your life. Your future self is sitting comfortably in this element that you have created, in this path, this golden path that you have laid out. And your future self has now poured the Ace of Cups onto the path. And it's reaching your present self. There's something that you are feeling right now. I'm hearing like, it's okay. Your future self is talking to your present self saying, just take that one foot into the door. Feel the worthiness, because I'm telling you right now, present self, we're sitting in our worth. We're basking in our worth. Just walk through that door. Your future self is telling your present self, trust your intuition, because what you see doesn't lie to you. What you feel doesn't lie to you. Keep moving. Keep moving forward. I'm seeing this new relationship take off. See, it's new. Aces. Ace of Pentacles, Ace of Cups. I'm seeing a new home. I'm seeing new love. I'm seeing a new job, new career, finances. I'm seeing new decisions, new choices here, Judgment, with the Ace of Pentacles. Something about making a new choice, making a new decision. It's almost like you've been waiting to make this decision, but you haven't come across the energy for you to make that decision yet, but you're coming to a point in your life where you are finally going to make this decision that you have been waiting to make. There's something about, I've been waiting to make this decision. Yeah, Eight of Wands. Enjoy. Enjoy. Take flight. It's like, just keep you. This is you on your golden path. This is you moving. But what I'm seeing here is communication with this person. I am seeing that this is going to take off for most of you. This is going to take off quite literally for most of you in January. In January. Okay. You're going to meet this person. There's lots of communication. There's lots of choices and decisions that need to be made. You have here the Emperor twice. When I'm telling you, you guys match each other's energy. You match each other's frequency. That's not a lie. You're going to anchor yourself here. Six of Swords. You're going to anchor yourself. You're going to anchor yourself in this love. That's crazy. I rarely use this deck. I've actually never even seen this card before. But I channeled for Capricorn. Some of you may be connected to a Capricorn or have Capricorn in your chart. But I channeled for Capricorn, anchoring into the star. Because a lot of people are coming into new dreams, new goals, new wishes, new energies for themselves. Okay? New energies for themselves. And I see you here anchoring into the star. You're anchoring yourself into this new love. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. You have here the World and the Ten of Swords, okay? The worst is over. The Ten of Swords, the World, completion. You're going from one world to the next. You're going from one to the other. The old world is no more. Hello, new world. Aces. Okay? Aces. This is what I have for you, Virgo. I know my readings are like getting longer, but it's just like we're in this new energy. We're in this space of abundance, and these energies take a lot of love and care. And I just trust that, like, what I say and the length of time that I spend on these readings, the people that really need to hear the messages, you know, are going to listen to what they need. And of course, just take what you need from the messages. I know that there's a lot. And I'm also just getting back into the flow of things. So this is just the way that my pace is at this moment. But I love you guys so much. And I just want to provide you with all the details that you need so that you can carry it with you on your journey and on your path. And I just trust that so much. So I love you guys. I love you guys. I hope that this helped, and I will catch you guys next time.